What are the stereotypes of Republicans?
White.
Old.
Greedy.
Selfish.
Racist.
Definitely racist.
What are the stereotypes of Black Republicans?
Oreos.
Uncle Tom.
Sellout. You must want to be white.
No connection to the Black community.
This is fun, right?
Black people support Republicans. Does hot support cold?
I joined the Young Republicans Club at school.
No, it can't be a Republican! Oh my God. Not a Republican!
But there was a time when Black Republicans were actually the norm.
African Americans, after the Civil War, are largely in the Republican Party, right? So this is where we get the phrase, the Party of Lincoln. The Democratic Party is largely invested in the segregationist politics of America at the time.
In 1936, things start to change.
Franklin Delano Roosevelt runs for president on the Democratic platform and introduces the programs of the New Deal. African Americans overwhelmingly help re-elect FDR to the presidency. They're part of this new Democratic coalition.
Fast forward to 1964 and
the Republican Party nominates Barry Goldwater as its presidential candidate. This is the same man who votes against the 1964 Civil Rights Act. His nomination encourages segregationists, white supremacists, the KKK, to come out and endorse the Republican Party. For many African Americans, this is it. Game over.
On the eve of the convention, 40,000 people, half of them Negroes, demonstrate against Goldwater in the largest civil rights demonstration since the March on Washington last summer.
In that year, only 6% of African Americans support the Republican Party.
And in the past half century, not much has changed. In the 2012 presidential election, only 6% of the Black vote went to the Republican Party.
When it came time to register to vote at age of 18, I checked the Republican box, didn't hesitate, handed that in to an African-American teacher because I went to predominantly African-American high school. You know, she looked at it, you know, kind of did a double take and was like, Telly, are you sure? And I was like, yeah, I'm sure I'm checked that Republican box.
Today, it's Telly's job to bring Black voters back into the GOP.
The Republican Party has to diversify. It can no longer be the party of just white men. At the end of the day, I'm trying to make the Republican Party more competitive. Many African Americans will say that Democrats take them for granted.
And in an era of movements like Black Lives Matter, neither party can afford to ignore racial inequality.
We need Republican elected officials to, you know, really step up and understand what is this Black Lives Matter movement about. They just see this as anti-police. The movement as a whole is saying that there are some serious issues out there impacting Black men nationwide. I worry myself when, you know, if I'm driving and I get pulled over by a police officer, you know, he's not going to ask me for my party affiliation. The first thing he sees is a Black man. Why are they intimidated by me?
And when it comes to Black Republicans in Congress, there are only three.
When we talk about limited government, guys, I'm not talking about cutting everything.
Mia Love represents the 4th District of Utah, a state where Blacks are less than 1% of the population.
I've had parents that made me feel very comfortable with who I am, to be proud of who I am, to be proud of my skin color.
She's the first Black Republican woman in Congress ever.
Do you feel accepted by the Republican Party?
I am here because there are people that don't quite look like me that said, she believes in the same things I do. In fiscal discipline, limited government, personal responsibility.
And a pull yourself up by your bootstraps mentality. For Mia, it goes back to her parents.
My mother and father immigrated from Haiti in the 70s. My dad came here with just $10, and he worked so hard. He worked 3 jobs at times. I remember I'd come home and I'd say, Dad, hey, I'm eligible for free lunch. And he's just like, hey, we're not there. Hard work, education. Thrift can take you far beyond what a government program can give you.
Those same principles are resonating with a new generation of Black Republicans.
I'm Mike Roundtree, political director for the Morehouse College Republicans, and we're primarily interested in spreading the conservative word.
When you're talking about government acting in our self-interest, I mean, I really don't see it.
But when it comes to the GOP's relationship to Blacks, these guys are trying to change the party from within.
What is it about the ideology of the Republican Party that attracted you to it?
The basic theoretical notion of personal responsibility. If you stay the correct course, then you will reap the benefits of that. And I believe that, you know, the platform of the Republican Party gives individuals that mindset.
And it gets a little complicated with race. Did we start out on a level playing field?
So that's one of the things that I don't think Republicans acknowledge. How could you possibly say that, you know, racism is not something that kept blacks back? But I do know that if we empower the individuals now, give them a hope for education, if we give them the opportunities, at least we'll be moving forward.
There's a piece missing to the pot. And I think it's really understanding people, getting to know us as people, not as a voter base.
Certainly those things are things that the Republican Party as a whole has to make a part of the platform if we're interested in having black voters.
So how do you unstereotype black Republicans?
You go to those places where the people may not vote for you, they may not even like you, but they need you.
Spread the conservative word, to let people know that there is something different out there. That the status quo, what your parents did, what your grandparents did, is not what you have to do. This is another plausible option that I'm doing, and I hope that you can benefit from it.
Many African Americans think that a black Republican is someone black who grew up in a white suburb, but there's many of us that are black and have lived in the African American community, so it's really showing people that we're real. And, you know, we are part of the community, we're here.